What I don't like so much about the Campark 4K is the button on the top, the shutter button. It's so hard to press. When it does finally click, it shakes the camera. So when you're taking a still image, it can blur. Now this is with the sun behind me. What I don't like so much about the Campark 4K is the button on the top, the shutter button. It's so hard to press. When it does finally click, it shakes the camera. So when you're taking a still image, it can blur. Now this is with the sun behind me. Now we'll try it just running across the lawn. Close up texture of brickwork from 12 inches, 1 foot away. And then we'll walk down under artificial LED lighting. The GoPro is set on linear field of view, distortion correction on. The Campark is set on wide angle field of view, distortion correction doesn't function in video mode. Let's look at some different textures here. Let's look at an engine. We have shiny aluminium, we have painted black. Painted green, slightly different colour casts according to the viewfinders. Now we'll try it just running across the lawn. Close up texture of brickwork from 12 inches, 1 foot away. And then we'll walk down under artificial LED lighting. The GoPro is set on linear field of view, distortion correction on. The Campark is set on wide angle field of view, distortion correction doesn't function in video mode. Let's look at some different textures here. Let's look at an engine. We have shiny aluminium, we have painted black. Painted green, slightly different colour casts according to the viewfinders.
Right, we're going to try a little bit of action video. They're both set on 2K 25 frames per second. And on the GoPro I'm using the lav mic to cut some wind noise down. The Campark doesn't actually have an external mic setting on this one.
Okay then. Let's try that. Wind coming into the helmet. Okay then.
when you buy a cheap action cam, you know it's not going to be as good as an expensive one. But that doesn't necessarily mean that the expensive one is that great. But we're not going to talk about the GoPro because we're supposed to be talking about the Campark and what you get for £50 and £400, just chalk and cheese. What you want from a cheap action cam is you want a good image quality. And this one, it's got a good enough image quality. It will shoot as much as 240 frames per second, but that's in VGA, which is just not good enough quality to use really in this day and age. It will give you 120 frames per second in 720p, which is kind of getting there. But in your 1080 upwards, you're only going to get 60fps. But that doesn't matter, really, because like you just want it because it's cheap and it's good enough.